SQL injection remains a relevant and serious vulnerability to this day. With its help, hackers can not only extract confidential and restricted information from various databases, but also, in some cases, gain partial or complete control over the system. All of this can be achieved using the free program, SQLMap. Impressive, isn't it? But wait, what is SQL injection, and why is it so dangerous? Let's examine how a database works in web applications. Imagine a scenario where a user needs to log into a website. To do so, they enter their username and password in the login form. By submitting the form, they send their data to the web server through HTTP requests. The web server, upon receiving the user's request, constructs a SQL query and sends it to the database, which searches for the requested information. If a record is found, the SQL server generates a positive response and sends it back to the web server, marking the user as successfully authenticated. So, what can a hacker do? A hacker can inject malicious SQL commands into the HTTP request itself, and the web server will redirect these commands to the SQL server. Thus, with simple manipulations, a hacker can gain access to all the data on the server. But what could be stored on the database server? Anything! Credit card numbers, usernames and passwords, personal user information, and much more. And all of this can be achieved using SQLMap. Intrigued? Let's get started. The comprehensive information about the program is available on the official website sqlmap.org. You can download the program and install it on Windows. However, you will also need other programs such as BurpSuite, ZapProxy, Metasploit, and others. Therefore, I recommend installing Kali or Parrot. They come with a complete set of necessary programs. SQLMap supports a lot of database systems, like MySQL, Oracle, Microsoft, and others. One of the exciting features of the program is dumping information from databases and creating a backdoor for remote control of the attacked machine. In this video, we will review most of the features. SQLMap operates in command line mode. However, enthusiasts have developed a version with a graphical interface, which you can find on GitHub. First, let's look at the options available for testing. Use the command sqlmap with option H to display the basic set of options. However, to see all options, enter the command sqlmap with option HH. There are quite a few options, but don't be intimidated. We'll cover some of them in this video, and you can explore the rest on your own later. For testing, let's choose the buggy web application. As an example, I've selected the first test, but you can choose any other. Since we entered a password to log into the application, we need to obtain the cookie. It is the cookie that contains the session ID, allowing web applications to remember users. To do this, let's intercept the request using BurpSuite. Once everything is set up, enter any word into the search field and see what we get in BurpSuite. We need to copy the URL, which is the value of the referrer header, as well as the cookies. So, copy all the cookies that you see. As a result, you should have the following command. I believe the URL and cookie options are self-explanatory, but let me explain the values of the other parameters now. DBS stands for obtaining the database name. Batch means using all default values. The thing is, when working with SQLMap, it constantly asks the user if they want to change certain parameters. To avoid the hassle of entering answers like yes or no, we use the batch option. Press enter and wait for the program to output the results. Scroll up a bit. Here, you can see which parameters are vulnerable and the techniques the program used to exploit this vulnerability. In other words, the program detected a vulnerability on the server and was able to access the database. Next, we see that MySQL is used as the management system. At the bottom, there is a list of all the database names. Such a long list is since several applications are running on the virtual machine simultaneously. Now let's try to determine which tables are present in the found databases. For example, let's take the NoWASP database. Again, execute the previous command, but this time apply slightly different options. In BurpSuite, right-click to open the context menu and select the Copy to File option. You can save the file anywhere. I will save it on my desktop. Why did we save the entire HTTP request to a file? In the previous example, we used URL and cookie options to specify certain parameters. The command became quite long, which is not very convenient. Additionally, there's a chance of making an error. Therefore, for simplicity, we save the entire HTTP request to a file, and SQLMap will later parse the file and extract the necessary information for its operation. The D option is used to specify the name of the database we are going to explore. The tables option indicates that we are interested in tables. As always, the result is displayed at the bottom of the program output. In this database, there are a total of 12 tables. Now let's try to explore the tables themselves, for instance, find out what columns they have. For example, let's take the credit cards table. Once again, run the familiar command, but with modified parameters. Great, we know the columns. Let's move on. It's time to finally find out what is stored in the coveted table. To do this, enter the command with the dump option. And here are the credit card numbers. We've only worked with a specific database and one of its tables. If you want to display absolutely all the information, including the database users themselves and their access rights, you can use the simple option All. Here's what the command will look like. In this case, I don't recommend using the batch option because it's better to skip some operations during testing. If the program detects password hashes, it will immediately offer to crack them. To speed up the process, I'm skipping this step. As you can see, quite a bit of information is displayed. Now, I would like to demonstrate how to gain remote access to a web server using SQLMap. The principle is quite simple. A script is uploaded to the web server directory, which is then executed and establishes a communication channel. Afterward, you can control the system by entering various commands. However, keep in mind that this attack will be possible if the directory where the file is uploaded is write or create file permissions. This usually happens if the system administrator mistakenly or unknowingly configures access control incorrectly. Let's look at the options of the SQLMap program. For managing the remote operating system, the following options are available in the Operating System Access section. Also, pay attention to the adjacent sections. Depending on your tasks, they might also be useful to you. Execute the command displayed on the screen. Note that the batch option is not used here, as we will manually select some parameters. Here, we are presented with four options. Since our server runs on PHP, press the number 4. In this menu, we are prompted to choose the directory where the backdoor will be written. We will choose the first option. If you are testing a remote server protected by a firewall, I recommend always choosing a reverse connection, meaning the server will connect back to our computer. And we need to specify our IP address and port for reverse connection. Here, we are asked to choose the type of terminal we want. It could be a regular shell, that is, a standard terminal for entering commands, and a Meterpreter. Meterpreter is an extended version of the standard command line that operates under the control of Metasploit. Therefore, if you are not familiar with Metasploit, I recommend studying it. The program is very useful. Let's choose Meterpreter. Then a 32-bit system. And Metasploit is immediately starting. As you can see, we established a communication channel with the web server. From now we can control it by sending various commands. Let's see what commands are available in Meterpreter. To do this, simply enter the word help or the question mark. All commands are conveniently divided into sections. With them, you can find basic information about the operating system and network settings, and there are also commands for working with files in the system. For example, let's enter the sysinfo command. It will display basic information about the operating system. Now, let's check which ports are open. To do this, enter the netstat command. The listen state indicates that the system is waiting for a connection on a specific port. the established state indicates that there is currently an established communication channel. However, if you want to switch to regular command line mode, simply enter the shell command. I hope you enjoyed the video. Leave your comments and share the video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to stay updated on new releases.